Well, at least I know you really are a cub reporter. Now it's a flush spreading up Johnny's sore neck instead of relief. Of course, any intelligence officer has at least 10 different names. Johnny should have known when this man chose to introduce himself with a choice of two, and they weren't even proper fucking names. Here's the thing, though, Johnny Murphy from the International Tribune, Geronimo continues. Now we've been properly introduced, I expect you think you have the full picture, especially if your last chapter and verse was anything to go by. You think it's perfectly obvious why this man was murdered. Better, you're sure who delivered the lethal injection. It wasn't what you were necessarily expecting, but it doesn't matter, because it's even better. What a story, huh? And now, your main concern, other than getting out of this hole before you piss yourself or worse, is that you'll never be able to tell anyone about it. You'll have to sit on the scoop of a lifetime. You've found covert intelligence operating in plain sight on top of a massive secret buried under one of the hottest borders in the world. You'll have to pretend you haven't got a clue. Because, of course, if you don't do exactly as you are told from here on in, you won't even get a chance to pretend. Johnny's neck pinches again as he looks up. What are you saying? That it's none of those things? Geronimo nods as he spreads his hands again, flexing his knuckles into the fetid air. That's right, my friend. That's right. We had nothing to do with this particular occurrence.